Should you buy Felseal? Well, if you've played Final Fantasy Tactics and you're thirsting for more, then you had better play this game. Each competently designed tactical RPG is a rare oasis in this vast desert of simpler genres and insulting mobile pretenders. Really, you don't have much of a choice. If you haven't played FFT, then you should play that first. Normally, I find it difficult to recommend older games because of the sorely dated graphics, but in this case, the old FFT graphics are unquestionably superior. Ultimately, I consider Felseal to be a great game, with that rating strongly propped up by the rarity of the genre. For those with more experience within the genre, I can say that Felseal has more in common with Tactics Ogre than Final Fantasy. There are no charge times or delayed actions, except for a single enemy that acts more like an environmental hazard. Line of sight is completely irrelevant, making it possible to shoot enemies while ignoring friends, enemies, and even solid objects. The walls seem to be designed specifically to avoid the most awkward of these situations, making it difficult to find scenarios where shooting through terrain is both relevant and possible. The result, however, is an overwhelming majority of flat maps and one-sided slopes, without walls or barricades of any kind. This constraint on map design is exacerbated by the fixed camera, which provides only one angle on the action and cannot be zoomed or rotated. The best parts of Tactics are still in evidence, though. Units take turns according to their individual initiative, as opposed to the combined team turn clusterfucks that have become inexplicably popular, most notably in the tangentially related, and still good, Disgaea series. Movement, spacing, and target selection are still the most important skills to master, while unit design and team composition allow some flexibility when applying these tactics. Proper facing at the end of each turn is crucial, with exposed backs leading to quick deaths. Units can select from as many as 26 classes. A character's current class determines what they can equip, and half of their available skills, both active and passive. Other skills can be chosen from among all other classes the unit has learned, including additional passive skills and a single counter. In total, each character can have 4 passive skills, allowing for a bit more flexibility and experimentation than Tactics offered itself. Further classes are available only to story characters and guests, including quite a few monster classes, though these are restricted to a single story character who is something like a blue mage. Felseal's story is fine. The plot points fluctuate between completely obvious and surprisingly sneaky, with the shifts coming on quickly enough to be disorienting. Essentially, you start as a fantasy cop and inevitably end up having to save the world. The characters are also fine, with no real standouts except for a jerk who gets just enough lines to remind you he's in the party. Story elements rarely interact with the game mechanics to provide new and interesting victory conditions. Basically, every battle ends when you've killed all the enemies. The hidden secrets and treasures nearly make up for this, though, with most maps having additional loot or even character classes hidden somewhere on the battlefield. As I suggested in the beginning, I didn't like the art style of the game. There is no reason for the sprites and portraits to look different at all, and some of the art, especially the backgrounds, looks amateurish. I'm not an art critic though, and you can see the game here and judge for yourself. I will say that I became acclimated to it over time to the point where it didn't bother me much at all. While the quality of the art might not have impressed me, how that art was used represents Felseal's best new feature. The clothing, complexion, hair, hats, and color palette can be customized for each unit, with options to allow both hats and costumes to either remain static or change along with the unit's class. While strong on its own, the feature elevates the game mightily when played for an audience. I personalized several characters for viewers of the stream, transforming otherwise routine crits and knockouts into dramatic exchanges. Viewers became invested in their character's success, and I was able to engage them in banter with their proxies as excellent props. All tactical RPGs should do this in the future. Really outstanding work here that seems obvious in retrospect. Mechanically, the game doesn't do much that hasn't already been covered in the genre. A few of the classes have novel aesthetics, but even then there are no attacks or spells you haven't seen before. Felseal starts out with a strong focus on managing status effects, both positive and negative, which spikes around the middle of the game. Here you unlock a flanking-style melee class with access to some truly nasty debuffs, who can easily cripple an unprepared team. Managing your own defenses becomes difficult as well. Being caught without the correct protecting buff can result in a one-shot death or a mid-battle nap. The theme quickly drops off, though, after the game's midpoint, when many enemies are immune to the most effective debuffs. Later classes focus entirely on damage and range, and even a fully buffed character can be taken out by back-to-back enemy turns. Early classes and normal melee attacks become irrelevant around this point as well, with the vast majority of adversaries and classes attacking at range in an area or both. Several of the most damaging skills in the game do require a unit to get close to its target, but these take several turns to charge before they become available and are generally grace notes to an impending victory. Notably though, tough melee units can no longer be placed directly in front of a mage or healer to protect against opposing melee assaults. Nearly every melee ranged enemy now has an attack that deals increased damage to any target up against another character or obstacle, while also dealing a full dose of damage to the character behind them. This would seem to encourage alternate formations when approaching enemy forces, but in practice simply makes defending vulnerable teammates less possible. Often clumping into a cross and stacking buffs and healing is still the best way to weather an assault. Speaking of healers, one of my favorite new mechanics is a passive skill that allows healers to share a portion of the healing they bestow on others. This makes them far easier to keep alive and more satisfying to play. I had three custom characters that my viewers wanted designed as healers, and we were all glad to see them function as a constant asset rather than a weak point to be protected. Unfortunately, two of those healers were male, which brings up what I consider to be the game's greatest sin and its most eye-rollingly boring reveal. Spoilers ahead for two of the game's secret classes. The final two classes, functioning as capstones for both magic and physical classes, are gender-locked. Male characters get a class with some surprisingly useless active abilities, the ability to equip any item, and a passive that lets them take a single additional turn if they kill an enemy. Female characters get a class that combines healing, exotic magical attacks, the ability to equip anything, and a version of dual cast that doesn't penalize the effectiveness of either spell cast. This makes the female class inarguably stronger and more flexible than any other pure caster. The difference is significant. The game essentially gave my two male viewers the finger while they watched the remaining female casters surpass them in every way. Obviously, this is some antiquated thinking, but even beyond that, I can't imagine why you would take an entire class and lock it away from half the player's team. I mean, imagine if they had chosen which characters could get either class completely at random. Even if you don't think the gender-locked classes are inherently gross, you have to admit that it's a bad call for the overall wellness of the game's mechanics and reputation. Six Eyes Studio, makers of Felseal, shame on you. What a colossal and avoidable boner this is, just literally as out of place and embarrassing as a public erection. You should really be rushing to patch this out before it gets modded. More forgivably, the game has a few mechanics that weren't fully refined and several annoying bugs. MP, for example, is a stat that determines how much mana your character can hold at one time. However, the game chooses to start every character with 0 mana at the beginning of the fight, and to slowly raise it every time the character starts a turn. Fights are over long before a unit would come anywhere near to storing their max MP, making the numerous bonuses to max MP on equipment conspicuously useless. It honestly looks like the MP mechanic was changed partway through production, and then no effort was spent updating the rest of the equipment to compensate. Some characters are instantly killed when enemies force them into water tiles, a technique that you are rarely offered an opportunity to recreate, but which classes can swim seems to be chosen arbitrarily. Enemies occasionally use abilities from beyond the skill's legal range with no explanation, and the RNG truly does seem to get stuck on occasion, with multiple 99% abilities missing in a row. To be clear, confirmation bias can't account for all of these streaks, many of which lasted for 4 or 5 rolls in a row. Most egregiously, the Protect skill seems to follow no consistent rules. The skill is designed to allow a knight to take a hit meant for another friendly unit, but in practice this rarely, if ever, functions correctly. Discussions online suggest that the descriptions of many skills specifically state that they ignore Protect, but I couldn't find any mention of Protect outside of the ability. Several ignore counter abilities specifically, which Protect isn't, but even if we allow for all of those, even regular attacks routinely fail to trigger Protect, even right after the knight's turn. In one particularly bad example, my team was engaging two enemies, both of which were standing by to attack any character hit by a single target attack. A third enemy used a ranged skill to hit several of my characters at once, and each of them received beatings from both knights in response to this so-called single target attack. My knight, who was standing by, completely out of the blast radius and protecting the scoundrel in the center of all this chaos, well, he stood there watching for all three hits. Even assuming that all of this follows the game's stated logic, it doesn't. The mechanics by which such an exchange would have been adjudicated would have been poorly explained to the point of non-existence. The injury system was a mixed success, ultimately saving me quite a lot of repetition. In Final Fantasy Tactics, a character who was killed in battle would have 3 turns to get back up or be lost forever. Falseal simply penalizes the character's status until they sit out a battle or two. This encourages more risky play and prevents the worst kinds of frustration, as the sensible thing to do in Tactics would have been to simply restart and replay a battle whenever a character was lost. However, the injury system becomes a little toothless once you realize you can simply have any of your characters wipe a low-level map in 60 seconds or so, relieving all of your characters of their penalties. Just removing permanent death would have had the same effect with less busy work, but I would have preferred if the penalties had been tied to story progress, wealth progression, or some other metric that kept them relevant. It was a good idea that I hope gets expanded on in the future. Despite the flaws, and especially despite the gender-locked classes, I do highly recommend Falseal to anyone curious about the game. You aren't likely to find another tactical RPG of this quality anytime soon. The game is fun and entertaining, especially with an audience, and if I pick it seems too much, it's only because I thought it could have been better.